Greetings, everybody. Welcome. Today, we're going to have a tutorial on generative AI. I'm sure you're following the news, what is happening in the world of generative AI with things like ChatGPT. So we're going to learn how to create an app today that connects to ChatGPT and allow you to access a world of information. Now, before we start with the tutorial, I would like us to quickly demo what this looks like. So I'm just going to quickly share my screen. So let me make sure everything is visible here. Okay. So I want to first of all demonstrate what ChatGPT app looks like. Let me move this a little bit out of the way. Okay. So that's that. And let me also actually make sure that I am able to be seen. So I'm going to quickly show the video panel. So here I am. Okay. So we're going to create an app that allows you to speak a query into your app. And then it's going to be sent to ChatGPT. And then the response, you can read it out loud. So I'm just going to do a simple one. In three sentences, explain to me the Big Bang theory of the universe. I'm sending it to ChatGPT. I got the response, and then I can have it read.
The Big Bang theory suggests that the universe originated from a singularity, an infinitely dense and hot point. Around 13.8 billion years ago, an immense explosion occurred, leading to the rapid expansion of the universe and the creation of matter and energy. This expansion continues to this day, shaping the evolution and structure of the universe we observe.
Okay, so this is just an example, and you will be able to ask any interesting questions to ChatGPT. Of course, we'll keep in mind that not every answer it's going to give us might be correct. But so let's learn how to do that. So I'm going to ask you to create a new project. So let us start a new project. Okay. And let's call this ChatGPT bot. I might have a few of them. So I'm just going to call, let's see if it's going to accept the name. Yep, it did accept the name. Okay. So So it is a fairly simple app in the sense that it has basically some buttons, et cetera, that you're already familiar with. So let's build the graphical user interface. So I'm going to need, first of all, a button. I'm going to need a text box. So I'm going to the palette, going to the user interface. I grab the button. Now I'm going to grab a text box. This is where we're going to write our query. I'm going to need another button. That's going to be my sending to GPT button. I'm going to need another text box, which we're going to have display the result coming from ChatGPT. And finally, I'm going to have a button that says basically, you know, read me what ChatGPT has returned. So these are my buttons. So I'm going to go to my screen. And first of all, make sure that everything is nicely centered. So I'm going to go center, so everything looks a little bit nicer. I personally like my screen color to be something other than white, so I go to background color. I'm going to just choose orange. Okay, now let's start you know, explaining what these buttons are. So I'm going to click on the first button here. I'm going to change its text to speak. I'm going to change its color to green. I like that color. Oops, so I accidentally changed the text color. I didn't want to change the text color, but rather the background color of the button to green. Okay, I'm going to change the shape to rounded. And then this button, we're going to name it, rename it, speak button, so that when we're doing the coding, we remember exactly what this does. Now, I click on the text box. I'm going to rename this to be, so let's see, we're going to call that speak text box. So that's the name of the text box. And we're going to make it, we're going to go to its properties and change the width to fill the parent so it is as big as possible. Normally, there's a hint there. I'm going to select the hint and delete it so there's no hint that is going to be blocking our view. I believe that's all what I need right now. And then for the next button, I'm going to call that, send to ChatGPT. GPT, that's what the text should say. And again, I'm going to make it rounded. I'm going to make its shape rounded, and I'm going to make its color green. I'm going to rename this to be send button. So because this is going to be how we're going to be sending information to ChatGPT. So I'm just going to call that send button. Oops, I accidentally typed the extra character there. So send button. So that when we're coding, we'll remember what it does. Now we come to the second text box. This is where the response is going to be pasted. So I'm going to rename it to response text box. Okay. And I'm going to again, so that's the name of the component. I'm going to delete where it says the hint. And what I would like to do, I would like to, again, set the width to fill the parent. But I also would like the height to be, so let's say, maybe 50% of the screen, if possible. So I have a lot of space when the ChatGPT returns with a response. All right. So that's that. Now, one thing we might need to quickly specify is normally the text box do not accept or multi-line entry. So I'm just going to click multi-line entry for this text box. And I should also do that for my speak text box to make sure that if there's a long text that needs to be entered, we can see that happening in a multi-line fashion. So last thing remaining is my last button. So I'm going to click on that and I'm going to call that button. I'm going to rename that read button. Okay. So that's the name of it. I'm going to change the text to say read. I'm going to change its font, the background color to again green, and I'm going to change its shape to rounded. Okay. So these are all things that you need to just make things pretty. You could choose your own colors, your own shapes, any way you want. But our graphical user interface is ready. Now, the only extra things we need to do are the non-visible components. So for that, we first of all go to media and we grab a speech recognizer. That's how we're going to be able to recognize the speech of the user. We need a text-to-speech in order to be able to read the text coming back from ChatGPT back to the user. And we're going to need an experimental component called the ChatBot. So when you drag and drop that, it's going to give you a dialogue saying, you know, this is experimental, etc. So you can okay that, all right? Now, for the ChatBot, if you're given an API key, you're going to copy and paste it here. Okay. And if there's any other information that is shared with you, like the model number, et cetera, normally it's okay to leave these things empty. You should have some quota of tokens you're allocated for free. But what I'm going to do is I know that I am over the quota. So I'm just going to copy paste my API key that I'm going to be using for this. I'm giving the information for the model number, so I'm going to copy paste it there. You can try running your app without these parameters, without these properties, and if it works, you're all set. But just for this demo, I need to enter these myself. So we are ready for the coding part. So let's think about what needs to happen. So first, we're going to need to figure out what happens when the speak button is clicked. And then we gotta figure out what happens when it is pasted into the text box and the send button is clicked. And finally, what needs to happen when the read button is clicked. So those are a couple of things we need to do. So I'm just gonna grab when speak button clicked, just to be ready. I'm gonna click when send button is clicked, get that ready. And finally, I'm gonna have when read button click when that's ready, okay? So these are sort of like some events that I'm expecting to happen, so I just have these ready. So the first thing that needs to happen is we need to get the speech recognizer, get the text that is spoken by the user. So I'm gonna do that. Now, before I do that, because we're going to use this several times, what needs to happen is we need to clear the speak text button in case there were other things there before. So I go to speak text button dot text. And what I do is I set it to an empty string so that if there was anything in the speak text box already, I'm going to be able to just clear that. What I can do is I can do a right click on this and duplicate that. And I also need to clear the response text box. So that way I have both of these things ready. Now we go to speech recognizer and we say speech recognizer get text. So what happens is the user has spoken when he presses or she presses the speak button. The text goes to the voice recording goes to Google and Google returns the text. And what happens is when Google returns the text, this event is provoked, which is after getting text. And what we would like to do is we would like to set the speak text box to this text that we have from Google. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna right click on this. I'm going to snap it here. I'm going to get rid of this. It's not an empty string anymore. What we need to do is get the result and display it at the speak text box. So this is what's happening. So the user presses the speak button. The voice recording goes to Google. Google returns the text box, and it is now displayed in the speak text box right here. Alrighty, so now we have the text of the user's speech. Now the user is going to press the send button to send this to ChatGPT. So we go to our chatbot components, components blocks, and there's a very simple looking block there called converse, okay? So what we need to do is we need to send ChatGPT a question. And this question is actually residing in this speak text box. So what I do is I get the speak text box text. So this is the block that I need. So I'm gonna send this to ChatGPT. Now, when you send it to ChatGPT, it's gonna go to OpenAI and it's gonna be processed and it's gonna return with a response. And what happens is the got response block from ChatGPT is going to be invoked. And then I have a response text. What I want to do is I want to set, and I'm going to duplicate that again. I want to duplicate response text box text. And I'm going to get rid of this string here. What I want to do is I want to now put the response text that arrived from ChatGPT into the response text box area, all right? Believe it or not, we're almost done. So let me just quickly go back to here. Speak button, paste it to the speak text box. You send it to ChatGPT with this button. The response got pasted into this text area. The last thing you have is when the user clicks on the read button, you want that text to be read out loud. So finally, we're gonna go to text to speech and we're gonna say, oh, speak this text that is residing in the response text box. So I go to response text box, text. Okay. So when you do that, you will get a response written, read out loud back to you. So we are at the point where we should quickly do a check. So I'm going to quickly actually reset my connection so we can see what's happening. So I wake up AI Companion. Let me share with you my visor so you can see what's happening here. Okay. So let's redo that. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to quickly scan the QR code. When I scan the QR code, let's see what's happening here. You're going to see that. So let's get rid of this guy here. Oops. Okay. So we have our interface ready. So I'm going to say something. In two sentences, tell me about Big Bang Theory. I send it to ChatGPT. I get a response back. And then when I press the read button.
The Big Bang Theory is a television sitcom that follows the lives of four socially awkward scientists and their interactions with each other in the outside world. The show is known for its humor, nerd culture references, and witty dialogue.
It's interesting. I was asking about Big Bang Theory as in like a scientific theory, but it taught, I'm talking about the Big Bang Theory, the sitcom. So it is interesting. It tells you that you really have to be careful when you ask a question. The response that you receive may or may not be accurate or relevant to what you intended. Anyway, so this is just a quick tutorial about how to create a chatbot using App Inventor's latest generative AI components. We're going to have another tutorial related to the image bot that uses DALL-E to generate images based on prompts entered by the user. Alrighty, it's been a pleasure. I will see you guys in another session. All the best.